So this is a quick demo on how to use the molview website. If you type molview.org into your address bar, it'll take you to this landing screen and you'll need to push close, which says you agree to their terms of use. Oops. So if we close this, you're going to end up with this large molecule shown on the screen, and you can see that it already gives you a 3D version of it. Once you get a 3D version of a molecule, what you can do is you can actually spin it. You can zoom in on it, and so it's a nice way to visualize molecules. We're actually going to start with a much simpler molecule, so I'm going to hit the trash to delete what was there, and I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to just select my carbon atom, and I'm going to draw the molecule ethane. So here we have carbon, and then since I want to have a second carbon, what I want to do is I want this to be yellow, and I'm going to click and I'm going to drag to add a second carbon. All right. So what this is automatically done, right? So if I want to look at this in a larger format, what I can do is I can click on this button, which makes the structure centered and it'll make it a little bit bigger. What we've done is we've essentially drawn a line bond structure for ethane. Okay. If you're not comfortable with this line bond structure for ethane, what we can do is we can actually draw it out. We can put our hydrogens in on it. So we know that the ends of these are carbons. So I can select my hydrogen tool and go ahead and I can draw a bond. So I make the middle yellow and I drag away. Here's my other hydrogen. There's three hydrogens on that carbon. And there will also be three hydrogens on this carbon. Now we see that it looks very large. So we can hit this center button again and it'll make it into our structure. Right. These vertices still represent carbons. Right. And now we show all of our hydrogens. Now to look at this as a three-dimensional molecule, I'm going to click this 2D to 3D button. And what that does is it updates the 3D model. And now we can look at ethane as a structure. Okay. For these types of molecules, it's giving a warning about the 3D structure being inaccurate. I wouldn't worry about that. Just hit OK. If you have questions about that, shoot me an email to make sure that your model is correct. So now we can spin this and we can see it's all single bonds. These dark gray spheres are the carbons and the white spheres are the hydrogens. We can zoom in on it, depending on if you can do a two-finger zoom with your computer. You can zoom in on it and we can see how everything lines up, and that's the three-dimensional structure. Okay. I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to trash this and I'm going to make another molecule. I'm going to show you a little trick. Let's make a molecule. How about we make 2-methylhexane? All right. So that means that hexane is our base. So we want to have a 6-carbon chain. So I'm going to use this tool right here to make a carbon chain. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. As you see, it tells you how many carbons you've put. All right, so that's good to know. That tool, it does not count the first carbon. So the first carbon is carbon number 1, and then there are 6 more. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So if you're going to make a 6-carbon chain, what you want to do is select the carbon tool, put your first carbon, and then add 5 more. So there are our 6 carbons. Now I'm going to put a methyl group on carbon number 2. To make this 2-methylhexane. So I'm just going to simply make that yellow. I selected my bond tool and I'm going to click there and it adds that carbon. We can look at a 3D model of this here, and there we see our 2-methylhexane. Okay. The other tool that I want to show you is that this will actually generate molecules for you. Now I don't want you to lean on this. Right? But I do want you to know that it's a thing. So if you'd like to know, for instance, what formaldehyde looks like, which is a molecule that we drew many times when we were talking about Lewis structures. So I can type up here formaldehyde. And it gives me some ideas. And I'm going to click on formaldehyde. And it's going to show me, okay, a bond line structure. So here we have a carbon at the end, double bonded to an oxygen. One thing to notice is that in this line bond structure, it's not going to show the carbons that are attached, the hydrogens that are attached to the carbon. Okay. What you can see in the 3D model is that, oh, there's our dark gray for carbon, there's our red for oxygen, and then there are two hydrogens. If you'd like to look at the hydrogens that are attached to it, I think you can do so by just touching that button right there. So now we will see our skeletal formula. All right, I can hit this. All right, it makes the geometry look a little strange in this molecule, but it shows all of the carbons and all of the hydrogens. Okay, just to reiterate, using that skeletal formula, what I can do is I can go back and I can say, okay, I want to redraw that 2-methyl hexane. Just hit enter, and there we have a skeletal formula or structural formula of 2-methyl hexane. If you'd like to see that in the bond line structure, just toggle this button again. Boom, there you go. Okay, so use this. If you need to use this structure, go ahead. But please don't rely on this. This website is helpful, but I want you to make sure that you can draw these on your own. If you have questions about using molview, please let me know, and I look forward to working with you on it.